Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sneha and welcome to Perio Hub. So to continue our series on a life as a dental postgraduate, today let's discuss about the Department of Prosthodontics. And to discuss his experiences with us, we have Dr. Rahul. So Dr. Rahul is a multifaceted person. He is not only great with his clinical as well as his in-depth knowledge into the field of prosthodontics, but also he's an author. So he has penned down novels as well as short stories, and the links to all his books will be in the description box below. So do check them out. So without wasting much time, let's bring him on board. Hello Dr. Rahul and welcome to Perio Hub.
Hello Dr. Sneha, how are you doing?
I'm doing absolutely great and thank you so much for taking out time and coming on board.
Sure, it's my pleasure. So I, Dr. Rahul Vishnoi, am here at Perio Hub to reminisce about my PG days. As most of us who have done post-graduation know that these are actually one of the hardest days and also one of the most funniest days of our lives. We like to joke about things which actually sometimes frustrate us a lot. And as you know, prosthodontics is a branch which, you know, we used to jokingly say that patient ke saath bhi, patient ke baad bhi. So most of the prosthodontists, they are habitual of spending 8 to 10 hours in their college. So naturally at the end of the day, you sort of fall in love with your college, the building, the people, your colleagues, your juniors, your seniors, your staff, your mentors. So those are very like beautiful days. So I did my post-graduation in prosthodontics from GDC Indore. I joined in 2012. I had gotten a general rank 51 in All India PG. It was a small college. There were only two seats per year, one from state, one from All India quota. But there was like so many patients there because GDC Indore is the only government post-graduation college in the entire Central India. And exactly in front of our college, there is a huge hospital, Maharaja Yashwant Rai Holkar Hospital, which is commonly referred to as MI Hospital. The doctors there used to refer us patients for maxillofacial prosthesis also, which used to end up in our department. And that was one of the reasons which I had chosen GDC Indore in my counseling, because I knew that students there were doing a lot of maxillofacial prosthesis work. So like this video at Perio Hub today is about my journey in PG, and also if I could recount my experience in ways that could make life easier for you in your PG. So I'll start with the initial days. All of us were supposed to do the preclinical, and as you know that preclinical of prosthodontics is exhausting and it's tedious and tiring, but it's fun also, you know, just to take impressions and all. So we started the edentulous preclinical work like most of us do, and so as you all know that dentulous preclinical, edentulous preclinical, thankfully we did not have any implant preclinical, but there was maxillofacial preclinical where we had to match the five different skin tones and we had to show it to our teachers. So dentulous preclinical work, as you know, we had to buy a jaw, mount the typhoes in it, start teeth preparation. Then we had to show the wax pattern, then we had to do the die cutting, casting, and in GDC Prostho we had to do ceramic application by ourselves also. We had a small ceramic furnace and all the ceramic materials were there, so we had to do the ceramic application of each and every case, whether it's a crown or a bridge, we had to do it ourselves. Now let me tell you about books. Yeah, so you have to study also, it's a post-graduation, you have to give an exam at the end of your third year. So you know, like prostho is a vast subject, and I'll say that it is not very easy or interesting to study, you know, sometimes because it's all dental materials and theorems and schools of thought. So we had, you know, like Devlin and Hayakawa were our CD, And then preclinical, I forgot to tell you that when we were doing preclinical, Rudd and Morrow, follow them. They are the Bible of preclinical and prosthodontics. But Rudd and Morrow is, it's like if you see on Amazon, it's 10,000 for 3 hard bags. And it's not easy to procure an ebook of Rudd and Morrow also. So we, what we did, we had, you know, very old ancient editions. So we got them photostated from our library, and we try and follow and read Rudd and Morrow. It's important to read a few topics in prosthodontics. Like if CD, you have to read at least from 3 books. Tooth preparation, you know, it's, they're not varying concepts. All the concepts are similar, you know, freedom of displacement and all. So you can study Schellenberg, Rosenstiel, but from CD you have to, Boucher, Devlin, Hayakawa, M-Cords, if you can afford it. Afford reading it, you know, it's like it's a very long process to read and then to retain also. So you can use Taylor for maxillomandibular and McCracken for RPD. Mish is a very interesting book. I have read it cover to cover. I think it was 3rd edition. So they may not ask you, but it's fun to know these things, you know. Like Mish has said that complete dentures are oral wigs. He was so dismissive of complete dentures. I'm sure Boucher will not, you know, see eye to eye with Mish on that particular statement. So these are the fun things which you discover when you read any book cover to cover. But that being said, I understand that, you know, as PGs we don't really have time on our hands to read each and every book. It's not practical also, and then you have to take care of your dating life also, right? You're in PG, so it's not as if you're just there for studying and doing practicals and doing all those patients. So you have to also, you know, go on the restaurant scouting scene. Kahan pe bhai golgappe acche mil rahe hain, kaun se restaurant mein kahan jana hai, kidhar khana hai, to wo bhi to pata karna hai na. So you can read different seminars which are available online. We have a tradition where seniors hand over the PDs, pen drives, to their juniors, in which this treasure trove of ebooks and LDs and theses. But don't make a habit of reading everything from the seminars, PPTs of seminars which you have. You know, like if you are doing an overdenture, if you are doing an eye prosthesis, try reading at that time, because when you are reading and correlating it in your clinical work, it's easier to retain. Also, like I said, if you are doing FPD, it's important to read teeth. Tooth preparation from Schellenberg and Rosenstiel, but which is the 3rd book which you should read if you are doing tooth preparation? I think it's Wheeler's Dental Anatomy. You have to know anatomy of a tooth before you are going to cut it up. You have to know in which premolar the mesial slope of the buccal cusp is longer than the distal and in which it is not. You have to have a basic knowledge of teeth in which you are going to do things. And second, as a prosthodontist, dental materials is very important. During preparation for PG, dental materials was one of my favorite subjects, and I think that Craig has actually written it better than Phillips. Things are more readable in Craig, and in Phillips it's more like you have to sift through the entire purple prose and go through chapters and chapters, and then you will come to know things. So that's it. Also, in first year you have to select your thesis topic, present in front of your ethical committee, start doing your thesis work. LDs are also there, library dissertations. One more thing which you have to study is GPT. It's very it comes handy in your viva. Before jumping on to third year, let me tell you that second year is actually one of the relaxing period, that you are not very worried about your thesis, you're not worried about your exams. So you have to do most of the patients in your second year. Try and keep a few exam cases, your special cases for your third year. In second year, we did lots of implant cases in second year, because our college was it was designated as an IGNU center, in which few students will come and place implants. So we had great exposure during that, in helping the students and helping them learn. We also learned quite a lot doing implants at that time. So in a way, we were fortunate that we could have an IGNU implant program in our college. And then third year, it comes third year. In third year, you are preparing for your exams, you are studying, you are finishing your cases. And as you know, that exam is for 2 days. First day is for CD and FPD preparation. And then second is for your major viva, your grand viva, pedagogy. And just don't take stress. But you have to start studying for it. And let me sign off by giving you a very, practical method of learning which has actually benefited me a lot. There's a three-pronged rule of revision. Like whatever you are studying, a new thing today, you have to revise it at least 3 times. First revision has to come after 24 hours. Second revision has to come after 7 days. And third revision has to come after 30 days. If you complete this three-pronged revision, 24 hours, 7 days, 30 days, there is a 90% probability that you will retain whatever you are reading. So try and revise it in these 3 steps and your PG will be a lot easier. Thank you. Thanks again, Dr. Sneha, for having me on Perio Hub, and all the best to all the guys who are starting their PG in Prostho or any other stream. All the best to you too. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for taking out time and coming on board and sharing your experiences. I really liked the method of revision that you spoke about right at the end. I hope this was told to me early on in my years. But any which ways, if you like this video, then please do like, subscribe and share this channel with your colleagues. And until we meet next, take care of yourself. This is Perio Hub signing off.